it's not only a financially successful way to run a business, it is in fact a better way to live your life. And just remember that sometimes, and this is the most powerful lesson, the pinnacle of generosity is sometimes letting other people help you. This referral network can be powerful.
What are those glass ceilings you're gonna try to break through? Procrastination, conflict avoidance, temper, scarcity, fear, all the stuff that you might have, how you treat people.
Crisp and clear articulation through the basis of a relationship that starts with generosity. Busting your back ends to serve will give people the time and the attention to lean in and understand your message. To take the time to allow you to influence them, it starts with generosity. And I found that out accidentally. Then all of a sudden, when you're there, you build a real relationship. You've now been given permission. You've been given a small window of permission to be you, to be genuine. Because the other component of generosity is intimacy.
Hey, listen, we got a great opportunity. We're not only changing lives one day a week, we got them 5 days a week. And that's what we're talking about here. We're talking about the ability to really change lives. And each one of you making a different choice, just like you do on Sundays, you can make them Monday through Friday too, and how you bring that to the workplace, if that's what you choose to do.
Here's a question for you, and what we learned through our research over time is if you're gonna build relationships with someone, if you've got a referral network and you wanna tap into that referral network, potential referral network, you serve them. That is your job.
Here's another belief system. It's not earnings for me, it's earnings for us. That was a big change too. Because once I realized that my job was to get us rich, not me rich, I made a big shift. But you need to lead your life and you need to lead your office as a group of people that have each other's backs. You gotta learn how to rely on those kind of lifeline relationships. You gotta set goals together with your team and your lifelines. You gotta learn how to fight in healthy ways, not in conflict avoidance or passive aggressive ways. You gotta diagnose your limiting behaviors and belief systems. You gotta commit to continuous improvement as a team and one day at a time, work it through. You gotta lean on each other for emotional support when the times are tough. If you don't have a team that is that, I promise you, that's your focus. Go build that team around you, whether it's in the workplace or out. Because it's so tough to change behavior. You can't change everybody's, all of their behavior. So you can't change everybody and you can't change everything about them. Despite the fact that the person sitting next to you, that may be exactly what you want to do. Instead, what you got to do is you got to pick your battles.